Hi everyone, Matt Nass here, and I am back to battling. It's been a while, but excited to be back and excited to fight some more. Not sure exactly what I'll be battling with, but I'm happy to give it a try. I want to try to check out Standard, see what new nonsense we can come up with. I was playing a lot of Tishar before. I'll probably still try some of that. What was this version? I don't even remember. Is this the one with like more self-mill stuff? Oh yeah, this is the one with Blood for Bones. Hi Numbers Messy, how's it going? I'm getting into the red a bit. Let me turn this down a bit. Yeah, that looks better. All right, so is this just like Andre's list, or did I just make this up? Okay, no, I think this is like kind of a stockish Scapeshift, but I can probably get a more updated one. Could try that. Not sure exactly what I want to try today, but hopefully we can find something sweet. Numbers Nessie, thank you so much for the sub. 22 months. That is awesome. We're almost at 2 years. Kind of crazy. Thanks for the welcome back. Yeah, I was in Barcelona for like 10 days. And then even before that, I was kind of not streaming as much because I wanted to focus on testing for the PT. Ended up playing Hogak and went 9-7. I was hoping to play a Sweet Brew, a Freed from the Real deck. So we'll have that for the... probably play that in the Super League instead, which should be pretty sweet. I was trying Elemental Scapeshift. I kind of like this. Maybe I'll start with this. This was a fun time. I'm trying to remember what I didn't like in this deck. I wanted more cheap cards. I think maybe just, even though it feels awkward with Scapeshift, just playing an Elemental that... I have not hit Lord, Brandon. I've hit Big Boss 2 at various points, but that's the highest I've gotten. Or at one point, actually. I think if I want to get better, the next thing I need to do for Underlords is to like kind of read guides and like study more, which I'm not super excited about doing. The Hydroid Crisis in this deck, I remember, did not seem great. Also, I don't think this is actually a 4 Scapeshift deck. I think it's closer to a 3 Scapeshift deck. And then also, I think I should be playing 4 Field of the Dead and maybe try a few more nonsense lands. But let me add Leafkin Druid. Let me go to 4 Field of the Dead. What other lands are there? Like if I do multicolored lands for green blue, I don't really want to play Guildgate, but I could see playing 1 Thornwood Falls instead of like a Breeding Pool. Play, okay, let's say that's good for green blue. For blue red, I have just Temple, Sulphur Falls, and Steam Vents. Oh, I need to do Show Unowned as well. Because I think there is, yeah, there's this. But like a Sulphur. I'll play 1 Guildgate over Steam Vents. Is that embarrassing? It is really good to have. And then for red-green, I'll also need... I think it's worth it to kind of make some efforts to improve your mana. Okay, Rugged Highlands over one of these. And we'll do a Guildgate over one as well. Sure, why not? All right, and now the deck's perfect? Is that what I'm hearing? Yeah. Now it's perfect. Boom. I still don't think this deck has a playable sideboard, I don't really remember, but whatever. Yeah, Brandon, I might do Underlords at the end of the stream again. I also might do a shorter stream just to get things started, because I'm still really tired. Jet lag isn't as bad this direction, I think, but it's still not ideal. I've gotten up pretty damn early the last couple of days, because I'm still a little bit on Barcelona time. I hope this Living Twister card is good. It's pretty sweet. So sequencing lands is a little more complicated when you have all these like bad lands in your deck, but if we go Rugged Highlands into Shock on Steam Vents, Growth Spiral, Guildgate, and then we can just play Living Twister normally. That's cool. What rank are you up to now, Brandon? Yeah, I'm on a bit of a good streak, so I wouldn't be surprised if I made my way back to Big Bus 2 at some point. I won a game earlier, got third, and then like I'm also excited. Apparently, they're going to make the ranks a little more concrete. I found it pretty frustrating when you couldn't like really. There was no like rhyme or reason to when you ranked up. So I'm excited to see some of that. Ooh, some Mardu nonsense. Okay, Mardu hero. We could potentially look to take out the hero with the Twister, depending on how things play out. This card's also pretty good with the Rugged Highlands. I guess you can just keep picking it up and gaining life. I think I should just play the Twister and then play Cavalier and then kind of save the Growth Spiral for later. Yeah, Cavalier is so damn good. I really like this card. Alright, well, I'm not gonna respond to that, I don't think. I don't think I want to pick up a land at the moment, given that I want to play Cavalier next turn. I fell hard back to... Do you mean boss 1? Because I think boss 5 is the highest boss. But yeah, that's rough. Oh, just one game a day, yeah. Alright, we'll take some more life gain, I guess. And we're still taking all different lands here, which is good. The next Cavalier could potentially even pick up a field. So we might actually be able to start kind of getting value the natural way. That's one of the things I really like about this deck. It does seem like that's a pretty common play pattern, just to get kind of natural value. Yeah, it looks like they're kind of token-y, but hard to get through the 5-6. I guess they could flip Legion's Landing if they're so inclined, but it's pretty costly. I think I'd rather kill the Butcher than the Hero. But I could regret that. I just feel like the Butcher is so snowbally and pressures my life total so aggressively that it's a big concern. I have a Soul Tie version of this deck. Yeah, I like the red cards, but I'm certainly not attached to them. I could believe that that is better. Oh, I guess I also didn't update Stream Decker. Let me do that after this game. I do have Elemental Shift as my current deck, which is good at least. So yeah, so it's a slightly off list, but should be roughly the right idea. Okay, so play field, get a 2-2. Then I think I want to hold the Scapeshift until I can make a crazy amount of tokens. So I'll probably just play Cavalier for now. Hopefully I hit another field off this so I get two more tokens. Yeah, nice. And then next turn is where things get crazy, where we can potentially make a ridiculous number of zombies, especially if we draw some lands or ramp. This has vigilance, right? Oh no, just reach. Okay, probably not attacking then. Just want to protect my life total. These decks can actually burn you out with Butcher and potentially some other stuff, so Judith. So I want to keep my life total as high as possible. Ooh, Carnage hurts there. The good news is every land we stay play is still going to make tokens, and if our Cavaliers ever die, We'll get pretty good value from that. I can also start getting aggressive here, especially after taking out that hero. Maybe just send both Cavaliers. We still have four blockers for their four attackers. That's not too bad. If they play Judith, maybe it's a little annoying, but even then, I think we'll be fine. I do want to... I think we're probably favored in a long game too, but I'd still rather clock them on the margin. And yeah, they've had enough. Flame Sweep is a nice pickup. And I think Grazer will be good here since we're going to be under pressure. Want to kind of lower the curve of the deck some. But Chandra is good. So we want that. Omnath, I think, will be good. Circuitous Route might be clunky. Risen Reef could be clunky, but I think it's too good to pass up on. What else do we cut? I could just cut Scapeshift on the grounds that it's really bad early and we'll probably win the long games anyway. Yeah, I think I'll just cut Scapeshift. A little bit weird sideboarding, but I think it will be good. I think we can just value them out. Ben Whites, what's up, buddy? Yeah, first nasty stream in a while. We're playing Elemental Scapeshift. I really liked this deck when I was playing it before I started focusing on Modern, and so I want to give it another shot. We'll see how the climb goes with it. So far, so good. We won our first game. I will warn you, Ben, I'm still pretty tired, and this might not be the longest stream. And I might also... do a little Underlords at the end, depending on my mood. So, I can't promise a ton of magic, but I can promise it'll be fun while it lasts. I woke up at like 6 a.m. today, Ben. Not too bad, but not ideal either. This hand is really clunky, but Flame Sweep is so good against them, and the Scry should help fix our awkward mana. Should we run it? Yeah, that's about where I'm at, Ben. I think I was just 6-6, actually, which I felt pretty fortunate about. But I tried going to bed later today on the hopes that it would make me wake up later, and then I just still woke up at 6, so it didn't really work. Like, I went to bed at, like, midnight or 12:30 or something. Do we run this? I really don't know. Yeah, we run it. We run it. Of course we run it. Ooh, that's a good pickup. Stomping Ground gives us kind of everything we need. It gives us the turn 2 Growth Spiral land and the turn 3 Flame Sweep land. So, pretty much the perfect card to see on top. Oh no. That could be a problem. So, we could play the Leafkin Druid as a potential blocker. But if it fails, it's kind of risky. Yikes, I think we should do it anyway. Don't feel great about this. Oh yeah, Nussie, Ben White's went a full game win ahead. He was 11-5 where Sam was 10-6. Oh, you're higher in ELO too? I think I'm lower than both of you in ELO then. I think. Ben White's is 15, Sam is 17, and I'm not even on the front page anymore. I'm struggling. I'm all down at 120. Yikes. Interesting that they have the Legionnaire in here. I wouldn't have guessed that card would be in this. The good news is if they blow me out with a trick here, it's not actually that bad, because then the flame sweep will work. But I'll need to draw a land. Land. I need a land. No! No land. Okay, fine. Yeah, and Elo Ben is slightly ahead of Sam. Two places higher. How many points higher? Let's take a look. It is 20. Oh, that's peak. Current, it's 2139 versus 2135. 4 points of Elo higher. Yeah, maybe it's Feather, actually. It looked, it had Hero of Precinct 1. So I didn't think it was Feather, but. All right, well. The good news is the Flame Sweep will still be pretty good. The bad news is I'm not sure it'll be good enough. So that's a little bit concerning. I'm going to try to hold on to the Field of the Dead and play it after. Oh no, well I could play it this turn. How am I going to get out of this though? There's like no way out, right? Because even if I sweep them this turn and then sweep with Chandra on the following turn, I'm just going to run out of life. Because I take 2 from Judith now, 4 from the Butcher, and then I kind of have to just keep chumping it, actually. So maybe I just play Steam Vents and get the chumping started and then hope that I can just chump a Dreadhorde Butcher forever, which seems basically impossible, but might as well try. Yeah, this game played out pretty awkwardly. The Butcher on the play is pretty obnoxious. And not drawing, and the tap lands also got me pretty good. If I had untapped lands, this game would have been pretty easy, actually. Alright, confirmed Feather. And I think we have basically no outs here. I at least can't think of any. Yeah, I can play Chandra, but it doesn't even kill their creatures. And even if it did, wouldn't help much. All right, on the Cerulean Drake might not be garbage. It does block Feather and Dreadhorde Butcher. Was it ever good, Ben? I know you like it, but I don't think it's actually good. The reach here could be nice on Feather. You always loved that card, but was it ever good? Risen Reef on the play should at least be tolerable. I'm not gonna Drake them. I think I'll have enough stuff on the play. You can be a mod, Ben. I think you mostly weren't a mod because it felt like you didn't really do the like mod type stuff, so I thought VIP was a more appropriate title for you. But it's really whatever your preference is. I don't mind if you prefer to be a modderino. Does Caroline? Yeah, Caroline actually does mod-like stuff. So the, playing this field does have some awkwardness attached to it, since I have some color issues, but I still think it's good to get the pure tap land out of the way, and I think I might be able to afford to shock on these. Yeah, Caroline definitely does mod things. Can confirm. So we can go Risen Reef, plus Grazer, put in Vents, and then we're kind of off to the races with a bunch of lands out. And double Risen Reef could be pretty nasty. Doesn't seem like their deck has a ton of removal either, so I would guess that some of this stuff will be pretty likely to stick, which I'm excited about. And we're also getting up there in terms of lands in play. That'll be land number 5. Sulphur Falls will be 6, and then we'll have a couple of Risen Reef triggers to get to 7. Also looking pretty good for Leafkin Druid's Kicker. Gonna tap for 2 mana, so hopefully we can pick up like a Cavalier or some sick thing to ramp into. Do I chump here? Probably not. I think this Grazer will gain more than 3 life over the course of the game. Oh, Chandra is pretty appealing. We would lose our Risen Reef then. Maybe I'll just go off with Risen Reef for now. And I can't play Risen Reef plus Chandra because I'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should I Chandra? I could also Chandra and plus or something, but that sounds crazy. What do I do? If I Chandra and minus, I kill... Nah, Chandra can get more value later, and I don't want them to know about it. I'm just going to play a Reeferino. I guess maybe it was better to play the land first? I'm not really sure. Well, now I'll just pass. Definitely more willing to chump block with Grazer now that I know I'm gonna Chandra them next turn. Yeah, that's kind of how Risen Reef works, Benjamin. That is kind of the deal with the reef. Just wait till I draw another elemental and just really go off. Field of Ruin. Okay. Just get a forest. So this only triggers on non-token. It's still going to do some pretty good work here. I think I might have... I guess delaying this trade does have value. So I guess I just block here. I don't know. So I do. If I do this, they kill Chandra, or they can kill 2 reefs and nug me for 3. And I'll just do it. And nug me for 1, I mean. Killing both Risen Reefs is definitely a bummer, but I think it'll be okay. I do kind of wish I did leave the Scapeshifts in now. Oh, they're going to send all 3 at the Chandra itself. Okay, so they're going to be at the mercy of these Risen Reefs. That's also reasonable, but it does seem pretty scary for them. And I guess I don't want to keep playing lands, because if I draw another Field of the Dead, I'd rather... Oh, I could attack. But yeah, if I draw another Field of the Dead, I'd rather set that up where I get the zombie. Dreadhorde Arcanist. They currently have no spells in graveyard. Okay. Ooh, nice. That is just what the doctor ordered. I guess I might as well grab a different land. Yeah, I feel like the Twister is going to be pretty good here. Should I just keep picking up the life gain land? That kind of seems great. Kind of loving that. Oh, well, there's Field of the Dead, so that's a higher priority than... Oh, whoops. Did not mean to attack with that one, but whatever. Yeah, Living Twister is going to be pretty good here at Alomi. I'm into it. I am into the Twister. Do I want to pick up another? Nah, I probably don't need to right now. The Twister is so good. Watch this. This is wild. Look how great that was. Ben White's, look at what I just did and tell me the Living Twister is not gas. There's four colorless lands. Should I start throwing some lands at their face? I guess I can toss an island upstairs real fast. Got him. Living Twister is so good. What? No! It was so good that game. It gave me extra life, made extra tutus, killed their creatures, killed them. Is there anything Living Twister can't do? That hand looked horrible. This hand looks slightly less horrible. I really wish we had an untap land here though. I will say that. Aw, thanks Ben Whites. That's very kind of you. Yeah, I think Canister actually only had one top eight with KCI. But he did probably play it online more than I did. Hand's a little bit clunky for the mono blue matchup. The most important thing in this matchup is just that you keep doing things. And our hand isn't doing a great job of that. So not loving that part of this whole equation. Also not loving the double curious obsession. But we can win, I hope. Probably not. Cavalier of Thorns does have reach. I'll say that. I kind of want to drop Leafkin Druid after I drop Risen Reef, but I'm really scared of getting Spell Pierce, so I'm just going to play it. But also, these mono tap lands are not doing it for me. Maybe I put too many in. Maybe you just need to play one of the Harbor Sulphur Falls and more of the Shocks if you do this. All right, we're dead. As a doornail. So, this card actually works even against flyers, which is a bit confusing, but Grazer is good, and I guess we probably want Spell Pierce. Don't want Scapeshift and don't want Circuitous Route. Don't want expensive sorceries. Chandra can't be countered, so that one's fine. Living Twister seems really strong here. Is Risen Reef the next weakest card? Because like Omnath will pick stuff off, Cavalier has Reach. I think it might be Risen Reef. That's the card that we cut, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, who is counting Ben White's? It's a fair point. Can't argue with that. All right, so we got the turn two Leafkin, and then we can try to set up Omnath with Pierce Up. Have I tried Blue-White Fires? Not really, Adam. If you send a list my way, I might give it a try. I don't really even have a great sense of what like I should be expecting in Standard right now, like what the metagame looks like. I really have not played much. Ban Scapeshift, Esper Tempo, Vampires, Mono Red, Jund Dinos, Boros Feather, Bant Ramp, Simic Nexus. Barcelona? I mean, the tournament only went so-so. I went 9-7. But it was pretty cool. I ate a lot of paella, which I love. And I had a fun time. No! No, I'm punished for... I guess... Well, no, I'm still pretty punished. I was thinking, like, if I played the mountain, this would be so much better. But I want to play this with Pierce Up, so that's the thing. But even next turn, it's going to be awkward now. So I did get punished for sure. Whenever you cast a spell during your opponent's turn, put a +1/+1 counter. Oh yeah, this card's pretty sick. If I can play Omnath with Pierce Up, it should defeat that. Oh, there's the Obsession. And another Storm Tamer. And it counters abilities too. Not ideal. I guess Omnath is probably just uncounterable right now. Oh, that's even better. That is even better. Because this is hard to counter and it's just a house. Steam Vents, probably? Need some more blue mana so that I can play stuff with counter up. Yeah, shoot Adam. Definitely curious. Oh, Trickster to force through damage? Don't think I'm too scared of that. Feel like, I guess Omnath isn't that effective here. Unless they tap out for a counter, then that would be pretty gassy. Yeah, this is gas. Nice. So now they can't defend with the Storm Tamer. So I can either knock out the Brineborn Cutthroat or a Storm Tamer with... I guess my creatures are big enough that the Cutthroat isn't my biggest concern. It's probably the Storm Tamer. Yeah. And I think I want the counters just on the Omnath so that it can compete with the Cutthroat a little better. Yeah, that's pretty crazy, Adam. The main deck ley lines were not uncommon at the Pro Tour. They make a little more sense there because you have known deck lists, but I don't know. I just believe anything at this point. Modern is the Wild West for sure. So Omnath will start drawing me cards with the next land. Also getting 2/2s now, which is nice. And then I think we can just chill. I think the longer the game goes, the better things are going to be for me. Especially given that I will be drawing cards as well. Gonna try to keep Omnath alive, so I'll probably just chump the Brineborn Cutthroat if push comes to shove. With a zombie. Hello! Living Twister again. Gonna be gassy. So, maybe next turn is when I start getting aggressive. I probably could this turn, but I don't see a strong need to. Look at Living Twister just being great. I love it. You got hooked? Yeah, that's fair. So now I put them in a bit of the squeeze. They can either draw their card off of this, or they can use the Storm Tamer one more time. Yeah, they're just gonna take the card. Then I'm gonna pick up the temple and get a little extra scry action while I draw cards and make 2/2s. Or maybe life is better. No, I'll take life. Who needs a scry? Man, they've had enough. Yeah, just the value is too much. Too much value. Same plan on the draw, I think. Yeah, I don't think things change except that it gets harder for me. But I don't think my actual decisions change at all. A pretty scary hand in this matchup. I think I'm gonna mulligan. I think I just want something with a little bit. Ugh. I think I should actually go to five here. Yeah, Grazer was one of the cards that I was kind of excited to keep a hand with. This looks fine. Ooh, Cavalier I'll take here. Can potentially play it the turn after next, depending on how things set up. So the Sailor is a pirate, not a wizard. I think people sometimes play the Lookout's Dispersal now as well. I'll take a land. I think just jamming a Cavalier next turn is so likely to be good if they play, like, Tempest Djinn or some such nonsense, that I think I will take a land here despite being a bit on the flooded side. And this is also Pirate, not Wizard. Okay. Now I'm not so excited about just jamming. I guess given my hand, waiting is not the way to go. Yeah, maybe topping that land was bad. Because, like, it's just too bad if they do just leave up three for a counter. Yeah, mulliganing to five just makes things tough. You're just so much shorter on resources. I think Chandra is going to be our best out at this point because it seems like they have a pretty juiced draw. Oof. Alright, I think we can... guess we don't have to pack it in quite yet if they just don't have a counter or something, but... not feeling great about the spot here. Boogaloo, I think we're pretty much dead, but I'll play out another turn or two. It's not a big deal, but I can't really imagine winning this. If their hand is all garbage and we draw perfectly, I guess I could see it. I guess this is probably the best route to victory. I don't know. Yeah, that'll do it. GG. They got us. The Mulligan 5 was too much. How'd I end up at the PT? 9-7. Good for 5 mythic points, and I think slightly more than the base level of money. I think I'll actually keep this on the play. Land heavy hands are good with this deck, and we have a temple, so we're slightly more likely to draw a spell. Have some untapped lands as well as tap lands. Like, field is just so good in this deck that I love keeping hands with that. I was 5-5 in constructed and 4-2 in draft. I played against Finkel in a Hogak mirror, and he had main deck Leyline, so he beat me. And played against quite a bit of hate, which I guess is not that surprising given how the metagame ended up shaking out, but made things pretty tough on me. I think I'll get the field out of the way. If I want to maximize avoiding shocking, I should play Stomping Ground here, but I think it's more important just to make sure that I can play as many cards on time as possible. And so that's what I'm going to prioritize. Because if I go Stomping Ground into Reef and don't hit a land, I could really delay Omnath and similar. Yeah, and I mean, it was still winning at such a high clip that it's kind of unbelievable. It makes me think that Hogak is really, really busted, which I kind of already thought, so. Hmm. So I can't actually get to six unique lands here. So I think... or to seven, sorry, I could get to six. So I think it's better to just play Omnath. Yeah, I'm not super excited about playing against Nexus. you think they emerge any before the GPs or wait with the new set? I probably should have done this pre-combat, but yeah, I could have gotten a couple counters actually. Yeah, I missed a couple damage. My bad. It's a good question. I don't think the emergency ban. Yeah, I think it's unlikely. I just don't know how much they care if the metagame at a few GPs is not as good. Like if there was another Mythic Championship that was at stake, that would be one thing, but for GPs, just guessing that they won't find it worth it. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I do this, I also get to draw multiple cards. Yeah, this seems better, I think. Yeah, there's 3 months, there's none for a while, and then, like, things get a little crazy towards the end of the year. But yeah. Oh, I think there is another normal chance to ban, yeah. So I don't know how exactly that factors in. But yeah, this should draw us two cards, I believe. Oh, wow. I was gonna play Field, but it's probably better to just play a Sulphur Falls and then play Risen Reef. That's probably gonna maximize my damage on them. I'm not sure about that, Adam, honestly. Modern is still a lot more powerful than it used to be, and I think it was better when it was a little less powerful. But I do think it would be better without Hogak. But A, Phoenix might just be too good. It could be pretty obnoxious. And B, like, I think things might just still be pretty awkward. All right, well, we'll see if this is enough to go off. They don't have a ton of resources to work with. Like, they basically need to have a Nexus, because they just don't have that many lands out, which puts a little pressure on them, but kind of like their chances from here, unfortunately. So they can play Search and still Nexus. Yeah, it looks like that's what they're going to do. And then from there, they still need a little more juice. Yeah, it's pretty awkward, Room Effects. It's definitely awkward when you're testing and don't know whether the ban list will be updated. I'm going to play the team GP in, where is it? Indianapolis, which is in like 4 weeks. Playing with Sam Pardee and Caroline. So that should be pretty fun. The Mighty Linguini in chat. Pretty excited about that. I'm also going to GP Vegas. Oh, did you make other plans, Caroline? No worries if you made other plans. It's no big deal. I can probably find another person. Yeah. There's also some pretty, like, yeah, I did do that, Caroline. There's also some pretty insanely powerful stuff in Modern, like Neoform and stuff like that I just find kind of obnoxious. But I don't know if it'll actually... What am I playing in Vegas? No clue. Okay, so... Here's the thing. I'm pretty sure they're gonna fog me, so I guess I might as well just get that over with. That seems like a clear step one. Okay, they're not even gonna pretend. So from there, how do I win this turn? It seems pretty tough. I can try and get up to 8 dudes in play and play Omnath. I guess that's my best way. So I think I want cheap elementals for that. This is coming in tapped regardless, right? Yeah. I just put that somewhere. I didn't really care where. Oh, okay. Well, that can do a little bit of burning, but not enough. Scapeshift could draw a lot of cards, but that doesn't really help us. I'm gonna have a pretty crazy turn here, but still gonna run out of mana at some point. And I don't really have anything that can punish Scapeshift the way I need to, but we'll see how hard we can go off just for kicks, and maybe they'll fizzle, you never know. Yeah, we're looking for Omnath, but I think we're out of mana at this point. So even if we found the Omnath, I don't think we could play it. Also, we didn't find it. Also, this still isn't lethal. All right, your turn. Oh, I should have discarded that land. I meant to keep all the lands. So that if they go for a fog next turn, if by some miracle they can't combo here, we win. Yeah, we were pretty far off, but so they get basically to go 12 card deeps here, 12 cards deep with 38 in deck. That's not ideal for me. That's pretty deep. To find a four of, their odds are very high. Okay, they found one. I'm gonna give up here. I think that's enough for me. All right, well, now on to the games that are actually winnable for us, where we have Spell Pierce and Negate. Again, Scapeshift feels pretty slow, and since they're not interacting with our creatures anyway, I think we'll be okay there. Maybe Scapeshift isn't that slow. I could play one. Yeah, this looks like perfection. I like that the Twister can burn them out through fogs, even though it's not the greatest in this matchup for sure. Thought about boarding it out. Which Planeswalker is the highest tier dialogue? I'm not actually an expert on Planeswalker dialogue. I don't have a good answer there. Maybe Chad has some thoughts. I kept this hand just because I think Negate is really good in this matchup, and Land Heavy feels good to me here. I guess I'll play Forest so that I can keep up Negate at least as an option. Probably not going to negate like a random Growth Spiral or whatever, but maybe I will depending on how my draw fleshes out. Now I'm a little more inclined to. Yeah, I'm going to negate this, actually. I don't want to keep up negate for the rest of the game because I have Circuitous Route and coming up next turn and just... Yeah, the more you have your turns planned out, the more kind of aggressive you should be with your counter spells. I should get a mountain or island so the Sulphur Falls comes in untapped, because I don't really care. I don't need to get Guild Gates or whatever. Yeah, I just got mountain and is it Guild Gate should be fine. So I think making 8 tokens with or I guess I would only make 7 with Spell Pierce up is pretty appealing. Because I want to leave up the one land. One of these for sure. One of these, one of these. One of these. One, one, one. Try to get tap lands out of my deck. Yeah, Growth Spiral is definitely one of the better cards in Standard these days. Our opponent drew Growth Spiral, but didn't really have the right setup for it. They were kind of short on lands. I don't really know why this Risen Reef would be useful. I think I just want Negate. Joe, thank you so much for the sub. Really appreciate it. Hey, Matt, are you going to be at MF Vegas? I am, Joe. I will be at MF Vegas. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm pretty excited about it. Even though GPs aren't as important now, I still love just playing tournaments in Vegas. So excited for that. You're not coming, Benjamin? No. Yeah, whatever. Oh, that's fine, Joe. I wouldn't worry too much. GPs, and in particular GP Vegases, are mostly just a spectacle. Like, what you're actually playing is not that big a deal. I guess this could have hit a field, so maybe that was bad to play the land first. I don't really know. I made it clear I was traumatized that you weren't playing, Ben. How is that rude? I guess maybe the one thing that could have been valuable about Risen Reef is it could have helped me make Omnath lethal. Well, yeah, I did technically conclude with and whatever, I guess. But... still. That's unfortunate. How many cards in graveyard do they have? 5? Should I just Spell Pierce this? Is this my best chance at this point? I think it is, because they're going to be good on mana, so I need to attack their card advantage sources. And they do already have a search in the graveyard. I don't know. Felt like that was probably the best I could do. Because if they just float, if I let that resolve, then they just float a bunch and play Nexus, I don't really have much recourse. Yeah, I think that list is a little bit off, Evens, but that is the rough idea here for sure. Yeah, this seems like a pretty bad matchup because they're one of the few decks that goes over the top of you. Oh wow, that's probably a mistake from our opponent. They can go to their end step, let the trigger happen, and then like float even more mana before sacking that. So they kind of lost 2 mana actually from that exchange. So yeah, in general when you're playing Nexus, try to sack the Memorials at the last possible second. I'm also surprised they're playing Thornwood Falls and Temple. Like, Temple seems like it would be enough tap lands with 4 Temples, and Temple seems way better, way stronger. That is a lot of reclamations. Hopefully they're still short on Nexus, though. I did deny them their card draw engine, which could help. I'm hoping. My fingers are crossed, let's just say. 37 cards in deck, so that if they only look at 4, their odds aren't great. They do have a lot of mana to work with, though, so any chemisters or things like that are going to help them out. Until they get a Tamiyo or a Searchdown, I won't scoop. Excuse me. Yeah, those are the things that usually cause me to pack it in. I don't think they have a Nexus based on the way they're floating here. They're also not doing any green though, which is a little bit concerning. I don't really know what's going on. Oh, they had one more trigger, okay. So now they get to draw 4 cards, and it's Nexus or bust. I mean, Fog could work. There's the Nexus, okay. Yeah, with access to this much mana, they might not even really need a permanent source of card draw to get there. Yeah, Chemisters is going to dig pretty deep, and they're down halfway through their deck. I think I'm still going to play on for a little bit, but this is getting dicey for sure. Okay, they whiffed on that. They do still have one more memorial left as well. So they have a memorial and a chemisters for sure, so they can dig at least 4 more cards deep. That'll put them to 22. And then they could potentially dig deeper. They're likely to be able to dig deeper even with the cards in their hand. And if they play an Nexus here, I will scoop. That'll be enough for me. That'll be satisfactory. Okay, kicking the chemisters. That is a good sign that they don't have anything. Because they would play Nexus before they did that. Have they shown an actual win con? No, but I don't care about that. That is not a big concern to me. Wait, now they don't even have 7 mana. I think they might have let a trigger resolve when they didn't mean to. They probably have a fog at this point, though, and I'm not sure I can really punish them. Yeah, they did have a fog effect. Yeah, I'm not even sure what I can do here. Like, I guess I try to draw cards and hope for the best. But it ain't pretty. Wow, they even had that covered. Whatever. All right, we're done. Stupid Nexus. Stupid stupids. Yeah, that matchup seems like it's going to be tough for actually most Scapeshift decks. And this one in particular seems quite bad there. Yeah, Luis beat that in the finals of GP Denver, but it did not sound like a good matchup. Regardless. I think I bottom field here. I think I just need more spells. Limptree, it would be cute when it happened, but I don't think it's actually worth doing. But yeah, the Arcane Adaptation would turn the zombies into elementals so that they would trigger Risen Reef and you could just keep chaining off lands. Thoughts on Urza and Modern? I really enjoy the deck. I don't think it's that good, Joe, but it's not far off. It's definitely decent. If Hogak were banned, I would definitely consider it. I honestly don't think you should play anything but Hogak when Hogak is legal. It just seems that good to me, but yeah, if that changes, then anything's possible for sure. Never feels great to be in these flooded spots, but if there's a deck I'm going to do it with, I'm glad it's this one. You're at least developing your lands to cast Scapeshift. The druids are really awkward, especially when they answer the Risen Reef. Oh, nice. We blanked a Thought Erasure. That's value. Okay. Guess we can go for this. Kind of want to play a land first, just so don't get spell pierced. Doesn't seem like that was a legitimate concern. Go for some green. All right, Scapeshift is live starting now, so that's pretty exciting. Omnath would also be pretty good. We could bop the Narset here. Nope. Instead, we will do nothing. Yeah, this deck does play a lot of mana in it. It might be too much. Okay. Ooh, Cavalier is decent. That's the type of card that at least has the potential to take over a game. And getting a field is nice. Yeah, that was at least a strong sequence. The Cavalier also, if they do decide to kill it, also gets to rebuy something. Probably Omnath. But also maybe Risen Reef. No random sign-up. I never finished Portal. It's on my to-do list, but I haven't streamed at all in a while, so I kind of wanted to focus on Magic for now, but I'm sure I'll get back to Portal at some point. Definitely enjoyed it, so despite it being pretty much entirely nonsense. Wow, they've blanked 3 Thought Erasures this game, but are somehow still up on cards. That's pretty wild. But this shows you the power of Field of the Dead. We flooded out pretty hard this game, but we might still win it. Yeah, is it Omnath or Ooh, another Cavalier is nice. I was gonna say, is it Omnath or Risen Reef that I would rebuy? But I guess if they might just not let me rebuy anything. They could trigger on the stack, kill this Cavalier, so I don't mill over like a Scapeshift or something. Not sure if they want to do that. Oh, Temple's nice. Get to dig a little deeper at least. Yeah, I think Omnath is probably what I'd want, but would Urza be played in KCI if it was unbanned? Good question. I think at least in the sideboard, yes. It's a pretty good grindy option. And if they like kill your KCI, it kind of gives you an alternate method. But I think it probably just would be in general as well. Now I'm actually going to take Risen Reef, because going Risen Reef into Risen Reef sounds really nice. Well, Scapeshift also sounds good, but they could easily have a negate in their hand or something. Yeah, let's just go for the Reefs. That'll be more fun at the very least. Yes, Jolly, I do think Scapeshift will be playable. Jolie, I do have Leafkin Druid now. Oh no, they got two of my scries with Enter the God Eternal. Savage. I do have Leafkin Druid in here now. Do I think Field of the Dead will be played when Scapeshift rotates? Yeah, I do. Yep. Have I tried Sultai Scapeshift net? Not really. I have not really played with Sultai. But I do think that's a reasonable... I think Bant, Sultai, and Teemer are all reasonable. I don't know which one's the best, but I wouldn't rule any of them out. Oh, well, we hit a Risen Reef anyway, so Mize. Boom. Sure. And let's go for the jugular here. If they want to double block, that's fine by me. I'll happily kill one of those and put something gassy on top. Probably just another Cavalier, honestly. I could also just put Scapeshift on top at this point. Might be about that time. Maybe they have negate, but I should at least put them to the test. I guess I only have... One. No, I do have two fields. Okay. Yeah, I'll just put Scapeshift back. That sounds like my best. They're probably gonna just mill me again, so this doesn't really matter. It is indeed Opta. Yeah, I don't know if Yerok's that good because it's so vulnerable to removal, but just playing Field of the Dead with Golos and Cavalier and like some more, it might push the field decks towards to be more mid-rangey and less combo-y, but that's probably even a good thing. So yeah, I'm not too worried about it. Okay, so it seems like we need to buy more time and try to just kind of rip Escape Shift. So let's just quad block this token. Hopefully they don't have another Disfigure or whatever. Yeah, I've been playing... that's cool, Opta. Yeah, I've been playing various Tashar version. Yeah, the Tashar decks are hard to play on Arena. I don't think they're impossible, but they aren't easy. I'll agree with that. Oh, so I'm actually maybe a little short on fetchables with Circuitous Route, because now if I drew one, it would just be blank. This is awkward. Yeah, the win cons are always pretty insane, Opta. Yeah, if you want to send the list my way, I'm happy to take a look. I've been trying every different version of Tashar. That is a lot of Enter the God Eternal zing going on over there. Seems like if we had drawn a normal number of spells this game, it would have been pretty easy. The Leaf Kindreds have seemed really bad. I don't know what to do about that. Okay, well, this has to be good. How many lands do we have left, though? We only have 19 cards in deck. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So I think we have 28-ish lands. Is that right? Let me just exclamation point deck real fast to pull up the list. Yeah, we have 28 lands, so I need to go for like 8. Hopefully I did that math right. So we definitely want to grab Field. I'll grab the Scrylands. Grab a Stomping Ground, grab a Breeding Pool, grab a Thornwood Falls, and grab a Swiftwater, and grab another Stomping Ground, sure. Oh, I'm just grabbing everything, I think. That's why it was. So now I get 16 tokens. It can't hurt. So I have a few different suggestions. I think I'll top this. So one kind of way to rent a deck for a GP is to buy all the cards and just sell them back to dealers. You'll get pretty raked on that. That's pretty bad. Another kind of way to do it is, I think some of the services like Mana Traders or Card Hoarder let you rent real cards. I've only ever used them for renting cards on Magic Online, but I believe they let you rent real cards as well. So that would kind of be the thing I'd look to first. I don't know. I think Mana Traders does it. That's probably the first place I check, if not Card Hoarder or one of the other ones. Oh, Mana Traders stopped it? Okay. Let me take a look. So I'm curious now. Yeah, I don't see. No, I see Paper MTG on here. I think it does exist, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, I believe it does exist. And yeah, maybe Card Hoarder or one of the other ones has it too. I don't know as much about those because I've never used them, but I wouldn't be surprised. Lanowarls, Citrus Supplier, Glowspore, Vulture. Yeah, this looks pretty close to what I was looking at. Yeah, I guess. Oh, yeah, so you only have two Salvagers, so you're a little less combo-y in general. Yeah. I'm not sure about the. About the Molder Hulk part of this deck. That might be tricky to combine. I could see some really awkward draws with that one. But yeah, that's cool, Opta. It definitely looks like a pretty good start. So yeah, we can just go for the face here. So yeah, even after that game kind of went on forever, they just didn't have counters in their game one deck, so Scapeshift off the top eventually got them. As far as sideboarding, I think we just want Negate and Pierce. Nothing too crazy. I don't want to cut Leafkin Druid. Doesn't seem like we need to go that fast, and they can kind of just ignore that one. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I mostly played with Mox Amber and Sentry when I played Tashar. Just because even having a zero mana thing to just play Tashar and immediately rebuy a three has felt pretty good. But I'm definitely low confident. Yeah, I've also tried... I've tried so many versions of Tashar. Like, blue has Diligent Excavator that's really good, and if you want more mill cheap creatures, you can play Wall of Lost Thoughts that's not bad, and then, like... I don't know. There's just a million options. Tameo is also pretty strong. If you're into a mill outlet that also gives you value, but then that makes your deck clunkier. It's cool that you get to play Llanowar Elves. I like that aspect of this deck, because... Tashar has like a lot of value-y stuff going on, but it's a little slow out of the gate, and Llanowar Elves could help with that a lot. I'd almost want to play Bugler in a Llanowar Elves version, because that's the card that gives you kind of the extra gas, the extra action. That looked like a mulligan. Just too awkward to draw. I think Living Twister is the card that we can probably live without. Maybe Second Growth Spiral is worse. Yeah, Twister. Get Twister out of there. I hate mulliganing against like blue black all one for ones decks for obvious reasons, but felt like a necessity in this particular game. But the Memorial Mulderhulk thing is pretty obnoxious for sure. It definitely is powerful. Let's just go for Temple here. In general, when I have like tapland heavy draws, I try to save the harbor in hopes that eventually it will go from a tapland to an untapland. Just because if I peel a steam vents or something. Narset again. Okay, so I'll make sure to grow spiral on their turn. The good news is if they minus Narset twice, I can pick it off with the Omnath so that I won't have to worry about the passive. Yeah, no, I mean, Bugler wouldn't be nearly as good if you didn't have the right setup for it. So I guess now I can go Growth Spiral into Growth Spiral into Field. Oh, no, I can't because of the stupid Narset. Or at least it'll be horrible. Okay, that's too bad, Joe. Yeah, my other advice, which is a little tougher, is I don't know if you go to a local store or anything like that, but the Magic community is really friendly, and so if you can find some people, there's a good chance that they'd be willing to lend you a Modern deck. I've been consistently amazed by how friendly the Magic community is when it comes to that. Hi, Flex. Not much, just getting back to playing some Magic. Still really tired from Barcelona, but figured I should at least stream for a little bit since it's been so long. Recorded a couple bandwagons today, so those should be up later this week or next week. Also, I need to at some point write the Modern newsletter, because I think... Okay, I guess I'll take this. I think one of those is supposed to go up as well. Let's just knock out this stupid Narset so I just don't have to worry about it. It's not that it's even going to be that inconvenient, it's just that I don't like worrying about it. Yeah, Flex, this is like an elemental Scapeshift. It's not even really a splash of red, it's pretty solid. I mean, it is the lightest color, but it's not that light. Oh, that's sad. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. But I have two temples, unfortunately. No! Swing and a miss. Yeah, Dave, in general, people are willing to, like, lend you cards. But yeah, if you go to an FNM or something, it's generally a bit more casual. But yeah, people will play a kind of the, you know, commonly thought of good decks. Yeah, Kethys is really powerful. I'm with you there. I definitely want to try a Kethys version of Dishar at some point. I mean, I've tried some. I want to try, like, another one. And going heavier on the self mill makes a lot of sense. At one point, I was trying to play all the colors, like play blue and Kethys, but maybe that's just too greedy. So I have 7 lands here. I could just go for Scapeshift for 7, but if I delay it one turn, I get so much more value. I think that's better. I don't know. Like, this way, my Scapeshift will actually make infinity tokens. It'll, you know, go completely over the top of whatever my opponent does. But they're way more likely to have a counterspell and stuff. Oh, Cry of the Carnarium there. Hopefully that was their last one, and the Scapeshift sneaks through. But I wouldn't count on it, given how willing they were to play that. Or this will get countered. Is it also possible? Yeah. That's sad. Yeah, Lazav and Fibblethip are both... it's good to have cheap legends, and the Abzan colors just don't really have great offerings when it comes to cheap legends. Oh, wow. Drawn from Dreams. Haven't seen that card in a while. Definitely a cute one. I guess I can try to make this work. Not optimistic, but I don't technically die by doing this. And if they do kill my Cavalier, well, I guess it's tricky. I can't, if they kill my Cavalier, I can't top deck Scapeshift. I guess I'd top deck another Cavalier or Chandra or something. I don't know. This is a tight spot for sure. In a bind. Dave, my next tournament is Grand Prix Las Vegas, and there will be coverage for that, I believe. So you could follow. Oh, they exiled my guy. Okay. So now I'd have to draw a blocker for Cavalier. I'd probably have to draw another Cavalier. Yeah, dead. How's life? It's okay, Rain. I just got back from Barcelona Monday, and I'm still very tired, but otherwise fine. And then I'm also playing the team... so yeah, Vegas is in a couple weeks, and then I'm also playing Team Modern GP in Indianapolis, but that one I believe does not have coverage, so that one you could probably follow, like, online the standings or whatever, but you wouldn't actually be able to watch a stream for it. Is my recollection, but I'm not 100% sure about that one, so please don't quote me on it. All right. Oh, Nick, yeah, the modern format was not great for this MC. It was pretty dang bad. This has to be a keep. The mana's awkward. I think I have too many tap lands in my deck now. It's felt pretty bad. But I do like this idea. I think I went a little too hard on variety for the lands. Guess my opponent, yeah, they were deciding what to put back for their London Mulligan there. Gross Spiral actually looks pretty good with this hand. I think I'll just top that. Because I don't really have something to play otherwise. I could bottom it hoping to draw like a Shockland or something. And then also just the Gross Spiral will like, yeah, just give me a lot more options going forward. This hand's definitely a lot less soft to Thought Erasure. Just have a lot of action. And yeah, it's all threats. I think I'll just Gross Spiral main phase. I don't really want this to get countered, I suppose. Alright, so if I draw a different land for my draw step, I can Circuitous Route making two tokens, which is pretty nice. I think just jamming here is good. I didn't actually think that would resolve, so I'm happy about that, but I just felt like jamming was the best option regardless. That is pretty nice. Two lands and two zombies. Also get to play Risen Reef into Living Twister next turn could be pretty nice, or potentially Risen Reef. I guess I can go Risen Reef Omnath, actually. Oh, or Risen Reef, that might be even better. I do want to be not 100% vulnerable to Cry of the Carnarium, so maybe Risen Reef Omnath is the safer play. Yeah, maybe I'll go for that one. I guess maybe I should have just drawn that. Now I'm confused. I think I should top this, because if I Omnath into a land, it's pretty nice, actually. Because I have 8 lands, so I'll draw a card from this as well. Put the counter on the reef, I guess, spread the love. That was not a bad turn. Put a lot of nonsense into play. I assume I'm gonna get Cry of the Carnarium tier, but even then I feel like I'm in a pretty great spot. And my next turn has the potential to be really bonkers. If they can't also answer the Omnath, things will get crazy. And if they can, things will still probably get crazy, but slightly less so. Because I can play Risen Reef, then play Twister, then like return a land, replay it, and every time I'm hitting a land, I'm drawing a card. This sounds pretty nice, and I could even Gross Spiral in an extra land as well. Like, things should get pretty crazy here. Are they gonna kill Omnath in response? Yeah. Maybe I should have led with a land. I kind of assumed they would just kill Omnath main phase if they had a way to kill Omnath. And I guess I'll just shock here. I might as well to pick up a land end step. Not a bad turn. If they have another cry, it would be mildly annoying, but this stuff's just gonna keep coming. It's not gonna go away, so. They are in a pickle. Oh yeah, going after my hand is not ideal here. The board is where their focus needs to be. because we have 10, 12, 14 power in play, plus the Living Twister represents quite a bit of damage. So, well over lethal next turn coming at them if they don't do anything. And even if they do, rebuilding is a very legitimate threat. Nyxless Cruelty. Alright, well, I'll pick up a land regardless. I guess I'll go for a land that scries. Might as well, right? Try to find some good stuff. And let's lead with Circuitous Route. Want to play that before I play my land. I guess this is probably overcommitting to the board, but I don't know. It thins my deck of lands too, which could be a good thing. And yeah, there's a Cavalier. That's nice. I could play that now because I don't think sweeping a Cavalier is very easy. I guess I am tapping out now, which is maybe bad. I don't know. Well, this is a comical amount of stuff I put into play. I guess I should have stacked the Cavalier trigger first, since that one was more likely to find a field. But I could have had even more tokens, but that doesn't seem like it matters right now. Could have also just left up Negate, since I don't really see a way out of this that doesn't involve resolving a Cry of the Carnarium. But I just felt like dropping Cavalier. Oh yeah, Overkill is the best. I do love a good Overkill Barnabas. They did have the Cry. Do they have a chump blocker for the Cavalier? It appears not. All right, got him.